So good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Dr. Gopa Kumar. We are in the cabin of Professor Dr. Gopa Kumar, who is the head librarian, university librarian of Goa University. And you're known to do your job very enthusiastically, but your special baby, as we were just saying, is your online.
Most of our online facilities are being used heavily by the university faculty as well as our all other stakeholders in the university.
Yeah.
First of all, it is our university index, library index,
yeah,
which is available online. It is at the URL www.libcat.unigoa.ac.in.
All your books are listed there?
All our books are listed there.
How many?
It is now reaching almost 2 lakhs.
2 lakhs.
The entire collection is coming to 2 lakhs. Along with that, whatever e-books we have purchased, its metadata also we have added to this collection, so that anybody who opens it will come to know about the e-books also.
That it's available.
Yeah. So that's a basic thing. So it gives a proper idea about what the collection has.
And your online site is very elaborate also, no? It's quite up-to-date, very up-to-date.
Yeah, yeah. It has a knowledge portal. Portal in the sense it gives links to various open source, open free sites, as well as whatever we have subscribed. We are spending around 2.96 crores every year for subscribing to e-journals,
yeah,
including Science Direct, Springer, SciFinder, like databases,
yeah,
we are subscribing, and all are linked there in this. So from a single space, you will get access to all these resources.
But to actually access it, you need to be on the campus
network.
That's
the facility,
yeah,
in fact. But during this pandemic, what we did is we used a VPN software to reach people so that it can be extended beyond the campus network. So people, all the faculties and research scholars are given with an access using a virtual private network. And that also is a free software provided by the InflipNet Center Ahmedabad.
Yeah.
So that is also there. So all these resources, whatever we subscribe, no, it is available to them at their home.
Doctor, as far as the public is concerned, is there any way they could interact, visit?
No, public, see, basically this is an academic institution. So,
right.
So there are some restrictions, otherwise, no, people can come and refer in the library. There is no restriction as such.
Yeah.
We allow many people used to come and have a membership so that they can remain in the library and read the books. We don't allow them to be issued out because basically it is meant for academics. The stakeholder of the university, holders of the university only. That's why we are not allowing it. But our all affiliated college faculty, students, all of them are coming here and referring books within the library.
Yeah.
And also we are allowing them to use the computers here so that they get access to the digital
resources. It's a very rich library in that sense,
huh? In fact, it is a rich library. We also have a good collection of local history documents provided by some of the earlier scholars of Goa.
Yeah.
They are kept here properly. We have maintained it and we have started scanning them also.
I see.
University is having a policy of openness, so we are trying to do our level best to keep things online so that it gets maximum coverage, maximum access to the knowledge.
That's a tough job and a lot of work involved.
Yeah, it's being done. We have a scanner purchased out of 17 lakh rupees, with which we can actually keep open a book and scan it and convert it into a PDF file.
This
can be uploaded into a digital library and can be given access to many people at the same time.
So, which are the spaces you recommend we visit today?
Today we can go to our major collection of the library, then the periodicals collection, and then the archival materials that we keep, and some of the old materials, whatever we have, we have kept separately, that we can show, and we can also show the thesis. Anyway, thesis, all thesis we have scanned and uploaded in a digital repository. That is also an important thing to tell about.
Yeah.
It is called Institutional Repository of Goa University. Institutional Repository of Goa, which has all the thesis. We have around 1,000 theses by now, and all are scanned and uploaded. Even though it is available in Shodhaganga, the National Digital Repository, it is also kept here. In Shodhaganga, you will get it as chapters only. You can download it as chapters.
Yeah.
Whereas in university website, you can download it as a single file.
And it goes up quite fast. No? People are quite impressed that
the same day when your Viva OC is over, that day it is approved. same day it gets
Yeah,
uploaded into this
I see.
IR. So it's the same moment it gets wide access all over the globe.
So it's no longer true that only three people read a PhD thesis, you, your guide, and one other person.
Never, never.
The whole world is
yes,
can
yes,
download it
no,
today.
No. See, it affects actually in a two different ways. I'll tell you, the impact is two. It gets access on a global basis. Another important thing is people cannot copy and upload things
yeah,
into this.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, it's a double-edged sword.
Yes, exactly.
You get credit, but you also will get the criticism when you deserve it.
Because of its wider access, we have to be very careful not to do any mischiefs with the thesis.
Yeah.
And I should tell you, we are the only university having such a lower level of similarity in our research report.
Similarity refers to plagiarism.
Yes, exactly. Similarity means similarity with the external sources of information.
Yeah.
So what will happen is if more similarity is there, the chances of plagiarism is more.
Yeah.
So we maintain, initially it was only 3%. Now it has been little extended, but still we are maintaining that 3% of similarity in our research. That is excellent. It gives a very good idea about the quality of the thesis. That's a wonderful thing that our university is maintaining.
Thank you.
Well, yeah.
Thank you, and thank you for taking us around also.
Yeah.